mannequin. That's the mannequin that probably got out and then got sucked up again. Hey guys, welcome to Project James Fight. Today we are gonna play some more Hello Neighbor. Now we are gonna do a very cool little experiment. So there's this tube that you can see right here, and any item that you throw at it, regardless of size, regardless of anything, it's gonna get sucked up and placed in the room behind it. And that's the room where you stand with the gun and you're shooting at the range, as you can see here. Now I've already stuffed a bunch of items in here, but we are not nearly there. There's so many more items in the game that we're gonna throw in there. So I started over with some of the bigger items, as you can see, the boxes and the chairs and the mannequins and whatnot. And then there's this thing. Now keep an eye on that. It gets sucked up, right? The pole that you put your heads on, and it just got thrown out of the room. That was very strange. I don't know if it like went through the roof or through the walls or whatever, but I'm gonna stuff it back in there along with the television and some other items and see if it can actually stay there. Because as you can see, there's a lot of items there. It's a lot of pressure on these items. Everything is gonna start rattling and moving as we put more items into it. And you can also see the light up there. It's actually gonna get a little bit darker as well, because there are so many items cramped in there. And for some reason, it's gonna get something going on with the lighting effect in the engine or something. Now, it's also really fun to see how the engine and the game works and how these items push each other around. Because as you can see, there's the item again. I believe that is where you put your hats on that went through like a wall. It's now kind of sticking through a door, which is very strange. I'm also gonna throw in all of these small items. And that's not the only thing. It got out again. And this time it's all the way over in the corner. It's at the shark. That's actually not an item. You can't pick up the shark. But for some reason, this thing will just not stay in. So I stuff it back in there and see if it will stay this time. Of course, the rest of these smaller items will go in as well, because it's all about volume. And no matter how small an item is, if you can stuff it in there, we're gonna do that. So there's some more big items. Now the boxes are actually pretty tough. Like, they're not actual boxes. They're not gonna be soft or anything. So they're very large. So we're gonna go downstairs, clean out the garage now. There's a lot of items in the garage. I actually didn't expect that. But these boxes, they have a lot of volume as well. So it's great to clean that out and have that out of the way. Now I also put in all of these secret items, like the bear and the crib and that mannequin and that chair, that big chair that's up against like a wall. I didn't record that, but it's all in there. Now this is where I'm gonna throw in one of the mannequins and see what happens. It kind of drags me along and then shrinks and then pops up. Here's a flashlight so you can kind of see a little bit better because the lighting is all blocked. But it seems like any item that you throw into it gets sucked up and just shrinks a lot and then expands again at the other end. Of course, the other end in this case is completely cluttered with items. So I don't know how that happens. Maybe that's why the items are kind of bouncing up against each other. So here's pretty much the entire kitchen going up. Now the thing is that any item that's behind that, it cannot actually leave. And if it does, it's so full right now that it's actually gonna get sucked up again. So these yellow pellets are what you actually shoot with the gun. They're like these tiny yellow cones. Those will not get sucked up for some reason. I guess that's because otherwise you shoot them and they get immediately sucked up. So I just threw those in. Now remember that thing that you put your hats on? I still don't know what it's called, but we're gonna see that in a moment, because for some reason it still got out. That's the third time already, and I don't know how it happened. So, you know, it's gonna go in. So I've got some more plates. Now these plates are pretty funny because they stay horizontal and they kind of fly up like a flying saucer. So I also grabbed all of these paper things, and here's what I found out. Another thing escaped, and this time is the lid. Now this is probably the biggest item in the game, except that it's very small. So I guess it can kind of see through a wall, and you can also see a box and a chair and whatnot. It kind of got pushed through and then sucked up automatically again, because anything that gets behind the counter actually just gets sucked up immediately. So there's always gonna be pressure building up in the room, and I think that's really cool. So I just drop down here, grab some more items, head over there, and now it's another item that escaped. It's the broom this time, another thin item. So those chairs, those boxes, everything that has like volume, it doesn't escape. And those smaller items also don't, because they just kind of heap up in the corner. So now it is time to throw in the big boys. These are the biggest items in the game. These are the trash cans. They have the most volume. They are known for glitching out things. You can like bunny hop and whatever with them. So stuff those in there as well. And there we go. That is just an absolutely ridiculous amount of items in there. It's not even all of them yet, actually. And again, the broom escaped somehow. I don't know how it's possible, but I make sure that I pick everything up. Here's where I'm very suspicious as well. I'm like, I know you can't grab me, neighbor, but I'm gonna keep an eye out on you. And by now you probably also realize that the sound is playing when the neighbor catches you and starts chasing you. He's not chasing me, and the sound usually disappears. It doesn't this time. For some reason, it keeps on playing. And you can see all of the smaller items. Those don't get pushed through walls or whatnot. They actually end up in the corner. So I'm able to pick some up here, throw them back in, and get a little bit more pressure going on inside. So here are the four last items of the game. I saved those for last. We're gonna see with the flashlight what this is gonna look like. So here's every single item in the game, along with a few extras like those paper planes, stuffed into one very tiny room. And there's constant pressure, you can see, right? So here's the flashlight, you can get a nice close-up. And there's just all of the big items blocking everything that's behind it. And even if they do get through, they kind of get sucked up again. So here's the mannequin. It's shaking, it's rattling, it's making a lot of noise. Up goes the head, and look at the mannequin. Look what it's gonna do. It actually manages to get through and get pushed back in. And here's where I accidentally throw my flashlight. Oops! So I kind of wanted to see like a close-up. I can still mount the gun. I can still shoot it. Except that nothing is really happening. You can see that the lighting is really bad. But here's where I run out of the room and I see this. What the hell is going on? It's making a weird noise, it's moving slowly, and it doesn't really appear to be in the room. You can also see a plate coming through the wall there. That's one of the corners that I was talking about, where all of the small items are pushed into. And here's more items. Look at the mannequin. That's the mannequin that probably got out and then got sucked up again. So it's not actually in this room. Look what happens when I touch it. Look what happens when I push it. 3, 2, 1. And it's gone. It just goes up, and I think it actually went back into the room. I suspect that it actually wasn't ever in this room, but that it only looked like that. So that it was kind of like glitching out, and somehow it was actually in the other room. And it's kind of the same thing with the lawnmower, except that it doesn't actually fly up and do all kinds of crazy things. So I manually threw that back in there, and maybe this time it will stay in there. So that's when I decided to take a nap. You can see the game is very laggy by now. I wake up, everything is buttery smooth again. All of the FPS that we can dream of. I went back to the house and everything is back to normal. Except that he locked a few doors. And he's looking out the window for some reason. I was like, neighbor, what are you looking at? So I take a look around. Nothing. So he just kind of sits there for some reason. The back door is also locked. So I went to the front. So the windows were the only thing in the entire game that didn't actually get fixed. I believe that's normal though. So everything is back to its place. Everything is normal again. So that's it, guys. If you stuff every single item in the game through the tube and then make it stuck in the room, all you're gonna get is a bunch of lag and a lot of sounds and, well, a very stuffed room that you cannot use anymore. So guys, thanks so much for watching. Please do like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next Correct JS5 video. Alright, oh, it's a body shop here. Yes, let's pimp our ride, boys. How do I open this? That won't open, will it? No. Okay, you know what? I have way too high expectations for this game. What was I thinking?